good now to whoever and wherever you are across the world, across this wonderful world and society in which we live. Thank you very much for tuning in and joining me. It's great to have you. Great to be here with you. I think we can all agree. No, we can't. We can't all agree. There are 8 billion of us on this planet and counting. And I think it will be really weird if we all agreed on something, on how we went about our business. Imagine all agreeing that would be kind of like ants. We just have one singular common purpose and goal, and that's it. Imagine if we all agreed, I don't know, just pick something, you know? It'd be kind of strange. That would not be a good thing. So, in a way, while we can't all agree, by the way, which is a generalization, it's very hard to avoid making generalizations. For instance, how often do you, or does anyone, any of us, I know I do, often say, always, oh, I'm always doing this, you're always, they're always, 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 always. But, you know, you see people do things a few times, and those things stick in your brain, and you think, oh, they're always, people are always doing this. Or you, right? You make mistakes, or, oh, I'm always forgetting my keys. No, you're not always. Yes, it might happen a few times, which happen to stick out in your brain. But there are plenty of times when you remember, right? So always and always. Yeah, so generalizing, kind of like the same thing with, you know, we all can agree. Some of us can agree with the nature of this topic. That's what I was getting to when I stated, I think we can all agree. I was going to say, I think we can all agree that society is going into the shitter, or has been in the shitter for a long time. But I don't think we can all agree on that. I think there are plenty of people that think society is advanced and modern and everything is great. And I think there are, in some cases, you know, we can, you know, maybe with advances of medicine, but, you know, advances of medicine make us live longer, more people, overpopulation, dense cities, dense urban areas, et cetera, right? So in generalizing, just to finish up on generalizing, you know, saying this, we all can agree, or I'm always doing, or men, or women, right, or kids, or whatever. You know, you're a guy, and you get treated by a girl or a woman a certain way. Maybe it happens a couple times, and then what happens? Oh, all women are evil. Same thing on the opposite side. Maybe you're a woman, or whoever you might be, right? Male, female, you know, whatever the gender, it doesn't matter. And, you know, maybe you're gay or trans, and you've been treated a certain way by cis people. You know, I'm a cis guy. And so you think, oh, well, all straight people, all cis people. So, and that's bad, because then the good, you're making all the, there's always going to be a few rotten apples in the bunch, but you shouldn't, you know, cast judgment on the entire bunch and call them all rotten. However, our entire species is rotten. So I'm a bit of a misanthropist. I've said this on other videos. I'm not sure if you're new here. I'm part anarchist. There are no true anarchists in the world besides the indigenous uncontacted peoples of the world that live actually out in the jungles. Those are true anarchists, as far as I'm concerned. So I'm part anarchist in kind of my mindset, my ideals, how I, some of the things I do in my daily life. You know, by not conforming and in my own personal evolution, which you're going to get to topic of this video in a moment. What was I just talking? Yeah, I'm part anarchist, part nihilist, part misanthrope. I have a love-hate relationship for our species, very creative, inventive, and things like that, you know, compassionate, empathetic. But there's also, that's the light side, and there's also a dark side to our species. So it's really not very rational to be a complete misanthrope, to just outright hate the entire species. You know, so, but I'm part, you know, part misanthrope. I'm part of a lot of things. Okay, but this is not about me. So, pardon me. And real quick about this shirt I'm wearing. I needed to grab something real quick, and I forgot I still had this. I made this myself. Anyone can do this. You can do this. You just go to, like a store like Michael's Arts and Crafts store, or go online, get a plain blank t-shirt, get a white t-shirt, whatever. And then they sell fabric spray paint that you, I mean, it's kind of, it's somewhat permanent on a fabric. And that's all I did, was just randomly spray black fabric paint on this shirt, and voila, I'm an artist. So, all right. So before we go any further, I'm sure you've noticed this dry erase board. So let me bring it down. I have, I put two little thumbtacks to hold it up there. All right. So let's get right into the topic of this video. Let me move my little Wi-Fi cordless, not Wi-Fi, well, cordless battery operated keyboard, so I can make room for my dry erase board. Actually, maybe I'll do it, yeah. Okay, so let's get into right to it without me talking for 15 minutes. And we'll get right to the whole point of this, which has been a thought of mine that's been percolating. Normally, I don't do, I'm not sure if you're a regular viewer or subscriber. Normally, I don't do back-to-back videos of any kind, like hardly ever. I like to mix it up, keep it random. But you know what? This is kind of, you know, this would kind of be random and mixing things up by doing two back-to-back talking videos. So it's very, you know, and to do a third one, well, you never know what I'm going to do next. Okay, so let's right here. I'm not sure what to, so we'll do, trying to figure out what I want to put. So, I don't know, off the top, we'll put, I'm going to write this. I'm going to write up here. Two words, and I will show you in a second. All right, so I wrote evolution slash progress. Okay, see that there, right? Okay, and then I'm gonna write alright, so we have evolution slash progress, and I should put quotes here around evolution, because we're not really talking about evolution in a scientific aspect. We're talking, turking. We're turking. We're talking more in a metaphorical, philosophical sense. Analogy. Analogical? What would be, how would I say analogy? When you say metaphorical, you can say metaphorically. When you say analogy, would you say analogically? I don't know how to say. Okay, let's move on, because my brain. All right, so we have evolution slash progress, obviously. The title of this video and the whole subject matter here, evolution, is more of a progress in the terms of progress of one's own life, mind and body, knowledge, maybe experience, and in terms of society as well. All right, so let me just put this down for a second. So we have society up top. And then we have you, and I put quotes, me, in terms of, we're going to talk about, I'm going to use myself as an example of evolution, how I've evolved, quote unquote, but obviously I can, you know, we're putting you here, and the me in quotes means me in terms of that, that's life is about me, you, the me of you. When we terms of me, it's not just me here, myself, in this video, but we're talking about the me that is you, okay? Because we're all put on this, none of us asked to be here. We're all, our parents just, you know, they got together and decided to have children. Or a child. Maybe there are some children born here. Any number of reasons. And so here we are. And while humanity, while people might need each other to get through life, you know, different people, you know, these different interactions and exchanges that we do for, you know, for knowledge and education and food and tools and building and things like that. No one human being, I don't think, could ever make it through this world without the help of another. I mean, I don't think just you're going to need at least the parent to teach the child. But even once the child, let's just say in a primitive aspect, a child was born to a primitive mother and father, they teach them how to hunt. At some age, the child will be able to do things on their own. And let's say that they become the only person in the world. Sure, they might be able to hunt, but they might not have the knowledge to do everything. To hunt, to skin, to make a shelter. There's a lot of things to do for one person to survive on their own. And we need the help of each other. We need the help of our parents to, you know. And in this society, one of the reasons why I think the society has devolved is because our parents no longer teach us hardly anything. We're born, you go to daycare, you go to school, that's where you learn all the necessary things to be a cog in the machine. I mean, yeah, you learn about your English, your language, your communication, so that's not so much a cog. But we're not really taught, I don't want to get into it again, but we're not really taught any tools to survive, okay? Because that's not, we don't live in a primitive society anymore. We are taught the things to do to earn money, you know, how to do math and how to bank account this and stuff like that, right? So you can get a job and all that. So that's one of the reasons why I think the society has devolved. There's many reasons. Just real quick, some of those reasons is nuclear energy, which creates nuclear waste. And there have been two incidents, one here in Pennsylvania, 3 Mile Island, and Chernobyl, where there have been nuclear, and of course, in Japan. Wasn't there a nuclear incident in Japan? A leak or something? I forget. Three incidents. I want to say Fukushima, something like that. And of course, dropping the atomic bomb on Nagasaki and Hiroshima, that on innocent people, that was horrendous. And all the machinations or the mac the machine the weapons of war and the trash, the landfills and the chemicals and the roads and just the destruction of the of so many swaths of fertile ground to put up cities and factories and blah blah blah, and I can go on and on and on. And so, but yeah, back to the real quick, the one of the reasons, the education, our parents bring us into this world, and it's just such a disconnect. The parents, maybe mom has a few, a month off from work or a couple months off from work. Here in the United States, you don't really get much of a maternity leave, depending upon the job you have. If you're working a retail job, I really doubt they're going to give the mom 6 weeks of paid salary to take care of her child. I don't think Target would do that. I don't know, Walmart. I really doubt it, right? So the in this society, the way it is, at least here in the United States, I don't know what. I'm not just talking about. We're not just talking about, I know UK, in the UK, there's more vacation time and stay-at-home time for moms, new moms or whatever, and all that. But I'm not talking just about that. But that's just one aspect of the de-evolution of society is the, or they're devolving, is, that we're brought into this world, and you go to school, the parents go to work, and there's a big disconnect right there. The home life, we're not really doing much together. We don't really learn things together, and except for the except for the same language, and maybe some of this, same math, some basic things like that. But we don't really have, families are just kind of torn apart by this society from, we're just, yeah. And we come home and yeah, so any but that's one aspect is how, we're brought into this world and then there's no cohesion of the family unit, so to speak, and you're not in, the parents aren't really teaching the child anything, and because the parents are off working and blah blah blah. So, all right. So, let me get my red marker. Probably have an idea where this is headed. So, society, when it comes to evolution and progress of society, at one point, in my opinion, peak society was when we were hunter and gatherers and quote unquote primitive. Indigenous people. We didn't have caskets. Now, we may have buried our dead and they just melted back into the earth and, were recycled. And we took from the land. There were no roads. Maybe some of the native inhabitants did cut down some trees and stuff, but it wasn't on such a grand scale as in terms of cities and making room for factories, right? So the further you go back, I think it is the further that society was better. I mean, we're talking thousands of years or tens of thousands of years ago, whatever. All right, so evolution progress of society pretty much. I wanted that. that to be a little bit longer, but that's good enough, like that. Okay. So that's pretty much, and this is pretty much where we are. I have to do the right part on the bottom here. If I'm doing a correct graph, we're going to put then, and then we'll put, all right, so I put then and now. Okay, so that's pretty much where society is today. And if we want to use a little bit of a comedic humor, we can draw a little gutter. We want to say society is in the gutter. Or we can go like this. And say society is in the shitter. That's a toilet, my best interpretation of a toilet. All right, so that is my perspective. And when I said in the beginning that I think we can all agree, I think you'll find maybe the majority of people, or a certain percentage of people will disagree and will think that society is advanced. And I do not agree with that. And I'm going to get into some of the examples to why. Or some more examples. Oh, I did go over some examples, right? Nuclear energy, nuclear waste. The proliferation. Let's talk about this real quick. This red line. So what do we mean by the devolving society? The proliferation of alcohol. Alcohol is not healthy. And you almost can't go anywhere or watch anything without seeing alcohol pop up. Now, I don't watch TV. I think I may have watched a couple sports events in 2023, a couple. I might have tuned in to the shit show. That's one thing we can call society, a shit show, a mess, whatever word, dog shit. Landfills, nuclear waste, nuclear energy, destruction of swaths of pristine lands and forests and prairies, proliferation of alcohol. You go to a restaurant and one of the first things that the server will come to your table and ask, would you like any drinks? Would you like a margarita? Here's our drink specials. You go to the supermarket here in the United States and now alcohol is now in almost every supermarket. They have their own little aisle. So it's almost, you would think that alcohol, like we needed alcohol to survive, like it's water or something. Alcohol is such a huge, the alcohol industry, huge. And it's not going to, it would take everyone to stop buying alcohol to shut it down. That's part of the problem with a lot of things in society. We can blame the CEOs, you can blame the companies, you can blame, all this, but it comes down to us as well. We're not, we keep buying, we keep supporting the system. I'm guilty of that. We put out trash on a weekly basis. I buy stuff. So I'm not trying to shame or guilt anyone. This is just a talk, this, whenever I come here to talk, it's not ever to shame anyone. I would think you might know that. If you're new here, you might not know that.
What
we were talking about. Yeah. So one of the reasons that society is in the shitter and the gutter is devolving is because, one reason of many reasons is the proliferation of alcohol, tobacco, right? We could say guns here in the United States. You drive your car and look on the side of the highway, all the trash. I sometimes think we're a trash species. I mean, look at the landfills, we put out, it's almost as if we create to make trash. You think about every product and everything that's, all the packaging materials, the water bottle, everything, the trash bag itself, everything ends up in the landfill. It's almost like we're a trash species. And I'm not trying to make anyone, you know, if you're struggling with something, the last thing you want to hear is someone calling you trash. I'm not calling you trash, as actually quite the opposite in just a moment. But I think when, you know, I hate to generalize, but when you just look at our species, it's almost like, what is our purpose? And you look at the amounts of trash and destruction and litter, it's like, what is our purpose as a species? We've come here and all we've done is destroy and trash and pollute. But it's not us, you know, per se. We didn't ask to be here. The system was built the way it is, and we are like born into it. But there's so many, we keep producing more and more of us, 8 billion and counting. You can't, how do you not, you would have to stop. You would have to no longer have factories, no longer create packaging materials and packaging products, and start truly organic in order to just no longer have any landfills. Anyway, but yeah, we love our stuff. I'm guilty of it. You know, I mean, look at microphone, camera, computers, masks. You know, it's very hard. We'd all have to go live out in the jungle to truly no longer create trash. Okay, so that's society. Society has gone in the shitter. I've given a few examples on why I'm putting that down. I've given a few examples already. From my perspective, you may disagree. That's fine. I have no problem anyone disagreeing. As far as I'm concerned, I may sound arrogant, but I'm just very confident in my convictions. When I come here talking about power and votes or this or that, I like to think that I'm right. And it's not that you're wrong. It's just I feel very strong in my outlook, and I feel that I've analyzed. I'm 53, and I have been analyzing and observing and reading and researching for at least 30 years, you know, at least since my 30s, so the past 23 years, but ever since I was a teen and stuff, I just have an analytical mind, and I'm able to just dissect things, and that's how I work. I may sound arrogant, and I may sound like I know it all, and all that, but it's just, at this point in my life, I'm very strong-willed, I am very confident, and I'm very, feel very strong in my convictions that what I come here and talk about is the truth. I'm not a god, I don't have a messiah complex, I just strongly believe in what I strongly believe in. So that's that. And that's not to say anybody else is wrong. You can disagree. That's fine. You're entitled to strongly have your convictions as well. Okay. So, yeah. So society. Okay. So let's get to the first two words of the title of this video, personal evolution. So this is you, right? You are a part of society. And then I'm just putting you down here. You're not necessarily down here. Below society, but I gotta, you know, in order to make this work, I gotta put you on the bottom, because you're gonna see just now, I was gonna draw a straight line, but I thought, let's do it like this, okay? And so society is going in the shitter. While society is in the shitter, headed in the shitter, the gutter, whatever you wanna say, you can take the steps necessary to evolve and rise above the trash society. Now, this is not about being superior, okay? This is about using your brain, because I know you have one. This is about being confident. This is about, while you might not have such and such education, you might be young, maybe you feel insecure, maybe you feel weak, maybe you don't feel things very knowledgeable, and so we sometimes will say, we'll sell ourselves short, we'll say, oh, I'm dumb, I'm a smooth brain, and that's wrong, okay? Now, everyone has, you know, unless you have some severe developmental issues, everyone has a very functioning brain and is capable of evolving and progressing and improving their lives to take the steps, right? I'm trying to draw steps there. I was going to draw a line, but I think steps is a little bit better. And maybe I should have had society like fall off a cliff. All right, so that's, let me just, give me a moment, I'm going to put this back up. Okay, so personal evolution in a devolving society. So as I've stated, and I could probably read off a litany of examples, because in order to have an argument and to put forward, you know, an opinion, you should have some knowledge or education to back it up, and some examples, especially some examples. You might not need to be the greatest speaker, but as long as you have some examples, look, like say, hey, you know, you shouldn't drink milk. And someone's saying, oh, you know, why? There's nothing wrong with milk. And maybe you don't know all the science of milk and blah, 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 and all, how it's made. But you say, oh, well, here's this reason, you know, milk is this and this and this and that, right? So as long as you have some examples, right? Of course, then someone could come back and say, well, here's some other examples that are good, right? But if we're trying to, so if we're trying to say, you know, speaking of good, we can say society is not in the shitter. Society is not in the gutter. We have advanced medicine. Okay, and I will then say the flip side of that coin is that we are keeping ourselves around longer than we possibly should be. You know, in the natural world, organisms, they just succumb to disease and all this. And while I think some forms of medicine and healing are okay, you get a cut or a scrape or a broken bone, you can splint it, wrap something around it, bandage, whatever. But we get into things like cancer, and I'm not trying to say that people that have cancer should just not take chemotherapy and stuff. I had a tumor. I still do. I have a peanut-sized it was peanut-sized. I'm not sure. I think it shrank a little bit. Growing right next to my brain stem in my left hearing nerve. And if it got bigger and bigger, it would push and compress my brain stem. And who knows what the hell would have happened to me then. Would I die because of it? I don't know if it continues to grow. And basically, real quick, it's called an acoustic neuroma, a vestibular schwannoma. Basically, there are protective cells on nerves, and the cells on the hearing nerve, close to where it connects to the brain stem, for some reason, these schwannoma cells grew and grew and grew and became tumor-like. But it's benign. It's not cancerous. And I went and got that treated. Our son was very young at the time. It was nerve-wracking. I had very kind of panicky existential thoughts of dread and all this. It was, you know, so, you know, compared to what other people have, it's nothing. And I got it treated. So while I got to watch, I don't want to become a hypocrite and say, you know, if you get a health issue, then you should just let it run its course. And even if you die from it, nobody wants to die, right? But that's kind of a problem. I mean, we have to kind of admit all these advances of medicine maybe keeping us around when we shouldn't be kept around. That's all I'm trying to posit here. I'm not trying to say that a kid with cancer should just let him die from cancer. Whatever. But it's just a philosophical thought, you know. So back to the whole thing of people saying, well, no, society's not into cancer. We have advanced medicine, we have science, blah, blah, blah. But I think a lot of the negative aspects of society, the nuclear energy and the nuclear waste and the two or three nuclear disasters that have happened, the landfills, the large amounts of destruction of the earth to create cities and roads and factories and farmland for cows and factory farm. There's a lot of solid examples and evidence as to why society's in the shitter. Not just that, but there's also a lot of narcissism. There's the politics. There's the worship of celebrities, the idol worship. There's the fascination with material goods and the money aspect. And then there's the unhealthy stuff, like the proliferation of alcohol and tobacco, at least here in the United States, and vaping and all those products. And it's not so much the decline of Western civilization. This is all across the globe. I mean, the United States is not the only country that has nuclear energy. I'm not sure. I think there are some countries that might not have nuclear energy, like maybe Greenland or maybe Switzerland. I don't know. I don't really know for sure. Okay. But we're not the only ones that create trash. We're not the only ones that have plastic products and packaging, and there are roads and cities and factories almost in everywhere, except maybe some more remote parts of the world. You know, maybe some certain, you know, Greenland or certain just remote places that are less populated and have small little houses and maybe a small road. And, you know, that's a small little impact on the environment, but I think you get my point. So I don't think this is, I think many people, not everyone, obviously, but I think many will agree that society is on the decline, not just Western civilization, Japan, Russia, UK, Canada, you name it. Cities, roads, trash, blah, blah, blah. Okay. All right. So while many of us can agree that, and it's a lot of it's out of our control as well. Okay. I'm not going to get into the whole thing about power, but we the people truly don't have any power to change things. Okay, I don't want to get into the whole thing, but the powers that be, quote unquote, the big corporations, the tobacco companies that probably have a lobbyist in Washington, the alcohol industry probably has a lobbyist in Washington, and the proliferation of alcohol and blah, blah, blah. So while the powers that be kind of control everything, people are still to blame. I'm not trying to blame people or shame anyone or guilt anyone, but people, it still comes down to the individual. And we can, while alcohol is a problem, we can stop buying it, but people don't. People love their alcohol. We love our drugs, which is another topic for a video I want to do, all the drugs of society. And I don't mean just drugs in the strict definition of that word. Other things that we might not often consider drugs. So while, and this is a problem, we always tend to point fingers at the higher ups, at the powers that be, the proliferation of alcohol and all this, but it also comes down to us. We have some individual responsibility. We can stop buying. we can stop buying the alcohol and the tobacco, and then guess what? They're not making money anymore. So if we're not buying the tobacco and the alcohol, there's not going to be any tobacco and alcohol at the restaurants and the supermarkets. So while they're creating it, is also our responsibility to decide whether or not we should buy it. But the majority of people continue to buy it. And that's kind of a problem, is people aren't stupid. And when they get together, the groupthink thing can be a problem. But an individual is smart enough to know better at a certain age. But when you have adults, huge flock of adults going to a sporting event like the NFL, they can't stop from drinking alcohol. And you might say, oh, well, it's just one drink. Okay, for that one individual going to that sport, let's say it's a dad and his wife and a kid, and the dad is just having one drink. But if everyone at that, the majority of adults at that sporting event are having one drink, how many drinks is that? That's like, what? I don't know how many fans there are that attend a stadium, but 40,000? That's 30,000 servings of alcohol. And that's just one stadium. I'm not sure how many NFL teams there are. 30 NFL teams, something like that. So any given Sunday, think of all in the NFL, and I'm sure there's alcohol served at football, soccer, throughout the world at different events. So, but just think of, you know, at concerts, you know, how much alcohol is served at all different concert venues throughout the world, and then all the bars throughout the world. So you can say, yeah, it might not be bad for that one person who only drinks moderately, but it's not just one person drinking alcohol moderately. It's thousands, if not millions, of people drinking alcohol every day, especially at some of these events. So it does come down to individuals. If the individuals as a group decided, you know what, ephemeral rift is right, we should all stop drinking alcohol. And guess what? Bye-bye. So there's self-control and discipline and using our brains a little bit to think that way and kind of shift. But I don't know. 2024, and I'm pretty sure 2025, 26, 27, 28, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, 6,000, people are going to continue to drink alcohol and continue to smoke and vape and just buy products. And I don't think anything is going to change until we reach some kind of tipping point where it's such an absolute mess. And then it's going to be too late. And people are like, damn, you know what? Ephemeral Rift was right. We should have quit smoking and drinking and buying and consuming back in 2024. But now we're screwed and all that. I'm saying that, you know, Ephemeral Rift said stuff, you know, facetiously, whimsically. I don't want to be a world dictator, but I do have an idea for a video, a role play type of video around that. Anyway, so yes. So, all right. So, right. So examples and, you know, argument of whether society's in the shitter or gutter or not, and perspectives, but from my perspective, society is just going downhill and has gone downhill since the Industrial Revolution for sure, with factories and technology and more machines, less work, less meaningful jobs, homelessness. And here's a thing to kind of support why society is going into the shitter. In 2020, there were over 224,000 emergency department visits for self-harm among youth. And suicide is the second leading cause of death for young people ages 10 to 24. So I don't want to, people can feel free to posit their arguments and say how society is great, but 10 to 24 year olds shouldn't be, especially a 10 year old, 11 year old, 12, a teen, shouldn't be contemplating suicide. Now, there might be factors like the home life, the parents are abusive, or bullying in school, in some cases of those. But again, that just backs up society, bullying, family members not treating their own family members correctly. And that if society was so great, advances of medicine and all this, and look at all and blah, and money and blah, blah, there, I would be able to type in, I typed in U.S. teen suicides 2023. That's just here in the United States. All right. And this is according to the CDC, Center for Disease Control. So, 15% of all suicides by youth and young adults between 10 and 24. In a wonderful society, if this was as truly a wonderful society as everyone likes to just, I don't know, man, go about their day just completely oblivious. If society was as wonderful and advanced and modern and just amazing as some people actually think it is, I would not have any results for teen suicide here in the United States, at least. So that is a perfect glaring example that backs up my red line of society declining and devolving. But of course, there's many other reasons, the trash, the nuclear waste, okay, all that. Okay, so here we are, almost an hour, and we can finally get into you listening or watching or viewing this, listening and watching, viewing. So while society is shit, it's a shit show, however you want to call it, on a decline, in the gutter, in the shitter, however you want to put it, you can take the necessary steps to evolve while society has devolved. So what does that mean? Look out for you. You have to look out for your own best interest. You want to be part of a group, whatever, that's fine. But at the end of the day, this life is all about you. I'm not talking about, it's all about me. That's the me in quotes. This life is all about me, whether that me is me, whether that me is my wife, that me is my son, that me is you, that me is your parents, that me is your siblings, that me is your child, that me is your friend, that me is a government official. We don't have to be, we're not conjoined to each other physically, nor do we have to be, nor philosophically, nor spiritually, nor politically. If you want to be a Democrat, a Republican, here I'm speaking here in the United States, I'm not sure what the other parties are throughout the world. And if you want to align yourself politically in one way, that doesn't mean anyone else has to be. We're going to jump real quick back to that whole generalizing. There is a bad mentality to have that if you're not with us, you're against us. Nah, that's not how that works. Every human being, myself, you, is entitled to live however they want to live, to think, and to align or not align themselves however they want. So just because the Democrats are this and they support this and blah, and I'm not part of the Democrats, doesn't mean I'm against them or I'm on the right. I don't want to be a part of the Democrats. I don't want to be part of the Republicans. I don't want to be part of this group, the religious. that group, I don't want part of any group. I don't even want to be part of the human race, okay? And I don't mean that I want to die. I just wish sometimes there was another alternative besides this fucked up society, okay? But there's nowhere to go. We're all kind of trapped and stuck. So, while society is shit, while there's, while people are a problem, in a way, they're bullying and the political this, and there's all kinds of stuff. You cannot deny that, okay? Unless you're just walking around completely ignorant and oblivious, there are problems, okay? However, you, the individual, can evolve and progress in your life, throughout your life, so that you rise above the trash and the filth of society. And I'm not saying that passive aggressive way of saying that people are trash. You could say, as I said in the beginning, our species does seem to be like a trash species with the amount of trash that we create and the destruction. I'm just talking about society as a whole with the nuclear this and the bullying and the trash and the littering and the alcohol and so many factors, okay, that why some of us will agree that society has gone into the shitter. But you can rise above that. I'm not talking about being better than other people, because that's just wrong. You know, this being superior, that's wrong. But you can be a better individual than who you were in the past. If you're young, you don't have much of a past, but you can take steps to avoid sinking down with the rest of society, so to speak. And I'm not trying to look down upon society again, but there are plenty of people that continue to not evolve and just continue to drink and continue to repeat the same bad habits and mistakes, I guess we'll say. Whether it's people that continue to be politicians, whether it's people that continue to drink when they should know, when it's people continue to smoke when we should know better. Now, I'm guilty. I'm not trying to say this is not about guilt, but I am guilty as charged, as they say. Our family continues to put out trash and we buy goods and all that. So we are as much of a problem. However, as individuals, we don't drink alcohol, so we don't support the alcohol industry, although we still use money and the internet, and we go to restaurants where alcohol is served, and we go to the supermarket where alcohol is available. So it's hard to not support the alcohol industry. We don't support them directly. Indirectly, we do. By it's hard to go anywhere where alcohol is not sold. Just by existing in society, we support all these things. It's kind of how it works. By just using the money, and that's just the basics. Anyway, so, because when you think about it, right? So you make money and you say, oh, well, you know, this is my money. I made it from this company. I don't support this. No, where do you think your money comes from? The money that's in your bank account, the money that you use to buy anything, has been in other bank accounts and other people's hands before you. It gets circulated. So there could be a pedophile and who has a job, and their money is going to eventually go into your bank account, and they're using the same internet and the same roads. So we're all interconnected with each other. Those of us who might be trying to improve ourselves are interconnected with those of us who are not. Okay. So the steps that you can take to evolve and rise above the trash, filth of society. And again, I'm not calling other people trash, because they still... Because the people that are continuing to make the same mistakes, drinking alcohol, and then all the politicians and all this, they have the chance to change. Okay. So while it's a shit show, it all comes down to me, the individual, to you, to the me, whoever that might be. Again, me, you, parent, child, teacher, whatever. To take this necessary steps to evolve and progress throughout our lives, and just for our own benefit. And again, like I said, I'm going to get to those steps in a second. But we're all, none of us asked to be here. Here we are, while every individual is, while we do need to kind of cooperate with each other and engage in these transactions and exchanges of knowledge and things like that, because not one person could ever make it through this life without the help of another, we can still remain independent, and we can still do the things and avoid the trappings, avoid the pitfall of society. And we all know that alcohol is not healthy. Tobacco is not healthy. We might not be able to change the world. Again, like I kind of alluded to or mentioned briefly, we don't have a lot of power. I don't have any power to say, let's not have any more landfills. Let's get rid of nuclear energy. Let's get rid of the tobacco, and let's get rid of the alcohol. And people want to say, that's my freedom and I have the right. And that's another thing. I think that's wrong. I'm not saying that people shouldn't have their freedoms, but I think there are some things we shouldn't have that we should agree on, like alcohol, tobacco, and guns, and nuclear power, nuclear waste, and all the amounts of trash and everything. So while society, right, it's kind of like, yeah, so while society is just devolving, we can at least, and we don't have much power or say to really change it and make it better. At least the individual, the me, quote unquote, whether that's me or that's you or your parent, your child, your sibling, your mom, your parent, your mom or dad, a friend, a colleague, a coworker, a neighbor, a teacher, a politician, whoever, we can take the steps necessary to evolve. And what do I mean by that? Evolve, that also has a lot of different aspects to it, not just alcohol and tobacco, right? Evolve and progress with our own health. That's very important, right? Exercise. And if you're someone who, is not heavy into exercising, at least, you know, go for a walk. They say the bare minimum you should do is about a 20-minute brisk walk a day. Not just a stroll, nice, fast-paced, brisk walk. 20 minutes. You know, once, twice a day would be great. All right, so there's the physical activity that is one step to evolving. Now the other, and I'm not saying that people, and then this isn't about like that people are, there's no hidden message here of like being better than other people. I'm not saying that people that can't work out, someone that's stuck in a wheelchair or someone who's really obese is devolving. Right, I'm not saying that. You know, even that obese person can exercise, and hopefully the person in the wheelchair has someone to help them move around. But I'm talking about people that are able-bodied and are able-minded, and we should know better, especially us adults, even as we go into transition from teenager to young adult. We can take the steps necessary to evolve while society around us is devolving. I don't know why I'm going like this. Society around us, I should be going like this. So exercise, that's one thing, right? Avoid, if you're young and you're listening to this, if you can go through life without ever having a drop of alcohol, obviously I'm talking about beer, wine, et cetera, liquor, or smoking a cigarette or vaping, then you already are just kind of set for life in that regard, because you're going to have less possibility of having health issues. So, you know, for me, I can give you, you know, I can use myself an example. I will in a minute. But so that's another step. You know, if you do drink alcohol, again, you know, everyone is free to do what they want. Obviously, that's why the world is probably a mess. Sometimes we don't really care, and then we have personal issues, and sometimes you just want to escape, and we do it in the bad ways. But if you do drink alcohol, you can always, it's never too late to quit, or smoke tobacco, or vape, right? So those are steps. Those are other steps. Other steps to evolve in a devolving society is by thinking, by taking time to think and thinking things through and trying to, you know, doing research and having more of an open mind. That's another step up, you know. And what I mean by that, it just looking into kind of like what I did. I'll talk a little bit about myself so that it kind of will explain some of the things that I did to personally evolve. So when I was 16 or 17, I kind of started smoking cigarettes because I thought it was cool. And then, but I never got, fortunately, my body I wasn't able to become addicted. And I only ever moderately smoked, but I would smoke, you know. I started when I was 16. I didn't smoke every day. It was, you know, I didn't buy cigarettes that often. I think maybe a friend would buy them and I would bum off him. I don't remember. I think I might have bought a pack. I'm not sure if I was old enough to buy cigarettes. I can't remember back in the 80s when cigarettes, what age you needed to be to buy them. And then as I got older and I got some office jobs, I picked up the habit of smoking on a break. You know, that happened. I'm not sure if I smoked too that often in the 90s, in my 20s. I know I smoked a little bit more regularly towards the late 90s, early 2000s. I just started to take smoke breaks more often. I'm not sure if I did that every day. But then around 2005, my wife and I, my girlfriend at the time, had thoughts. We were together for quite a few years at that point, and we were planning on having a child, and so I stopped the smoking and drinking. I also kind of got into drinking when I was 16 or 17 because a friend, the parents had alcohol in the fridge in their basement. And we tried drinking alcohol and all that. And then, you know, I also got into cannabis. So I dabbled in those things. I never did heroin. I never did cocaine. I never did anything harder, quote unquote, than liquor, alcohol, and cannabis and cigarettes. I never did acid or anything or mushrooms, though I would like to try that once in a safe setting. Just for the experience. And alcohol and tobacco and cannabis, I would partake. Cannabis, I smoked about a half a dozen times throughout my life, and I quit. I haven't had cannabis since around 2005. And so when we were getting ready to plan to have our child or try to have a child, I wanted my body to be as clean as possible. And so I stopped the drinking and the smoking and all that. And my wife was never much of a smoker or any of that at all, hardly. So she's more, her body's more pure in that regard. Since around 2005, I haven't had tobacco. There was a video or two where I did smoke a cigarette, but that was just for video purposes. But generally speaking, I haven't had tobacco since 2005 on a, you know, and it was, again, it was moderate. I only drank moderately as well. It is July 2024 and I am now, free of alcohol since, January 2022. So 2 years and 7 months alcohol free. And I am now in a point in my life where I am completely sober for the first time in my life since, well, for the first, you know, first 15 of years of my life, I was sober until I started to get into cannabis, tobacco, and alcohol because of a certain friend. That was a good, he was a good friend. But he, I think this one friend kind of maybe got me into it. Never forced, but it was kind of a mutual kind of thing. Hey, let's try this. But he, this one friend, teenage friend that I met in seventh grade, was a new student transfer. We kind of hit it off and we kind of became best friends. He had access to the cannabis. He had a contact. Yeah, I can't remember why or how he would. He was a white kid. But anyway. So since 2005, I haven't had cannabis. I haven't had tobacco. And then I would moderately drink alcohol, go out to office party or with coworkers after work, go to a bar. And then I did the beer review videos on my channel. And I thought at that, because at, we had our son, and then I kind of got back into enjoying alcohol. And then I was trying to do the different beer reviews and independent things. And then I started to just not feel right in my head from the alcohol. And obviously alcohol is depressant. That's a fact. It's a depressant. Not to mention all the other health issues of the mind that it can cause. And of right, the liver or whatever. Around 2017, I first tried to, 2017 or 2018, the last beer review I did, I tried to quit alcohol for good. But then I would find myself like 6 months later saying, oh, I'm just going to have one drink. No big deal. And then I got to a point, so from 2017, from 2018, my first attempt at quitting alcohol, which I didn't really quit for good. Finally, around, my wife brought home a bottle of wine that she got from someone at work, because you know how people just get people alcohol as a work gift. It's just a thing. You know, they don't know if you really drink or not, but everybody, it's like everybody assumes everybody drinks anymore. So it's like, here, have alcohol. And so, and brought home a bottle of wine, and I had some of that. And then I was like, you know what? I don't want this anymore in my life. And so since January 2022, New Year's, it was not long after Christmas that we had that wine, I have been alcohol free. So I am now completely sober for the first time in my life of all these drugs. And I have, and so I haven't been sober like this since maybe a couple points in my 20s, but definitely the first 15 years of my life, I was completely sober until I was introduced to tobacco, alcohol, and cannabis. And then it took from about 16 or 17 to, let's see, I'm 53 into my, so I was 51. Yeah, I was 51 when I gave up alcohol for good. So that is, let's see, we'll say 16 to 51. That's 35 years. 35 years of my life, I was dabbling with alcohol, tobacco, and cannabis. And it just finally, you know, it, fortunately, I was able to live long enough. Fortunately or unfortunately, however you want to look at that. Yeah, so I am sober for the first time in my life. And there are quite a few different definitions of the word sober, actually, which I read in a dictionary. But let me just pull up here the word sober, and there are quite a few meanings for that word. Not intoxicated, obviously. Abstaining from drinking alcohol or taking intoxicating drugs, right? sparing in the use of food and drink. Right? So I'm kind of like that. I don't eat massive portions and blah. Sometimes on occasion, I've gone to an ice cream shop and I've had this big giant sundae. It was like 5 scoops, but that was like one time. And I do like to have a nice good meal. Maybe I'll have a steak and maybe I'll have an appetizer before that and a salad and I'll have a side and maybe dessert. So that's quite a lot, but that's pretty much as much. I don't eat massive. I don't have the type of body that would let me do that anyway. But I am sparing in the use of food and drink. Abstemious is actually that word. Abstemious. Marked by restraint, especially in the eating of food or drinking of alcohol. So that is a word I think I've learned for the first time this year. Abstemious. I don't think I've ever even heard of that word. But marked by restraint. Right? And how many things, not just food and drink, but restraining your anger, restraining from so many different things, right? So back to sober, marked by sedate or gravely or earnestly thoughtful character or demeanor. Very sober demeanor, which I've, kind of like this video. Unhurried, calm. Now you think about the nature of my channel and my videos. Sober. Marked by temperance, moderation, or seriousness. Moderation, temperance. That's those words, right? That's just another more steps. Being sober, another step on personal evolution. Subdued in tone or color. Showing no excessive or extreme qualities of fancy, emotion, or prejudice. So interesting, the word sober. We'll have to do a video on sober, and it makes me think of Tool's song, Sober. I absolutely think, in my perspective, I used to be a huge fan of Tool. I used to be a huge fan of so many artists, but I'm 53. I'm no longer as emotionally volatile. And I'm no longer, music is no longer a drug for me. And like I said, I gotta do a video about the drugs of society, and music is one of those. I was a huge fan of heavy metal and the aggressive type of stuff, and I don't have as much aggression as I used to, and I went through some stuff as a kid. I wasn't born into privilege, born to a middle class family, just my dad worked. And most dads worked and most moms stayed at home. It was, the further you go back, the better, I'm telling you, the further you go back, the better society was. Only the dad had to work. Mom could stay home with the kids, even though we still went to school, right? And on one income, you could have a decent little house, right? And you could have a car, maybe a used car, but that's fine. You get to where you needed. And it was just, the further you go back, the more simpler, just better. And you start to see, man, society was peak just when you go all the way back. And it's just gotten worse. So, so what were we talking about? Sober, right? So I am sober. So if you, for the first time, just completely sober, 2.5 years off alcohol. And like I said, I was a moderate drinker, but I was still indulging, and it just wasn't very smart. So it's not just about exercising and being healthy and making smart choices, but it's also about the mentality, personal evolution, having a mentality of wanting to just evolve into the best person you can be, progress into the best individual you can be, whether you have any physical or, mental, disabilities, I want to say another word that prevents you. I didn't want to say ailments, but if you, evolve into the best, progress into the best person you can be, despite any limitations, physical or mental limitations. So avoiding the alcohol and tobacco. If you can get through life I don't have anything wrong with cannabis. I don't think cannabis should be smoked. I think maybe a moderate use of ingesting, eating cannabis. It's just a plant. Who really knows if human beings should be ingesting cannabis to begin with? You know, why does this plant exist? You know, why does any plant exist? Why does the tobacco plant exist? All these plants existed, and then we've taken them, our ancestors, you know, took from them and ingested them or put them in something and made a paste or whatever and found out that, hey, these properties affect us a certain way. I like this. It gives me a funny, nice feeling. And a couple commenters, when I talked about plants, and I talked about something a couple weeks ago or a couple videos prior to this one, and people commented how, I think it was, I was doing a coffee video, and people commented about how caffeine and or different properties of these plants are actually a natural insecticide poison for any bugs that would try to feed off the plants. And we actually we actually drink poison. And it's funny when you think about it. But we drink, and you know, you could take that and metaphorically or philosophically and think we love our poison. When it comes to alcohol and tobacco, they're poisonous. I'm of the believer that organized religion is poison. Government is poison. Capitalism. There's a lot of poisonous aspects of society when you think about it. Again, when I bring up religion, you know, personal faith, you know, it's the large scale religion. It's the Pope. It's the dogma. It's all that stuff. It's the constant preaching. It's having a church with a sign on the side that's broadcasting a message to everyone that passes by that have faith in Christ, in Jesus Christ, and you shall be saved. And then what's that saying? That if you don't believe, you're not going to be saved. Right? And what kind of message is that? Come on, this is 2024. Right? If the Catholic Church, I'm just going to make a real quick rant. If the Catholic Church wants to, and the Christians and all that, they want to believe that there is a God, that's fine. But don't do this thing where you're preaching that if you don't join our club, you're going to burn in hell. Don't, you know, just stop. You want to believe in your thing you believe, but don't do that thing where you're trying to tell everybody else, right? Because I don't go around as a non-believer saying, hey, God doesn't exist. I don't have a sign on my front lawn. God doesn't exist. Life, there's no afterlife. When we die, that's it. I don't have that sign saying, you know, being an atheist. And so that's my one of my other problems with religion. Constantly gotta, you know, anyway, so. But yeah, to me, religion is poison. So, what were we talking about before that? I got a little sidetracked there. We're talking about different poisons, being sober, blah, blah, blah. So we are now almost an hour and a half into this video, hour and 15 or something like that. So yeah, so it's just, you know, there are different steps you can take to evolve like I have. Opened up my mind and I researched, opened my mind up to different cultures. I enjoyed the different food that I will say. While society might be in the shitter, the one good aspect, the one kind of shining little gem floating in the river of shit of society is the different food and cultures and colors and clothing and music, right? So there's a few pretty gems, in the turd of society, okay? The good food. You know, I've tried different types of food. The gyro, the Greek gyro. Some people call it a gyro or a gyro or a gyro or a gyro. I think you call it gyro. I love that. A lamb gyro. And I love that tzatziki sauce. It's a white creamy sauce. Normally, I don't like those white creamy sauces, like they're mayonnaise based or something. I don't like the whole mayonnaise stuff. I don't like cream cheese. I don't like Thousand Island dressing, except like on a Big Mac. But I like the tzatziki sauce. I think it's because it has some onion and other things in it, so it doesn't taste so like mayonnaise-y or whatever it's made from or made with. But there's a lot of different foods, and you know, and the art. But unfortunately, I think that despite those little gems in the turret of society, there's a lot more. The negative stuff kind of far outweighs just you know, nuclear waste and the destruction of the planet to build cities and roads and all this stuff I always mention and rant about in every one of these videos I do. But you can take steps to evolve like I have. It doesn't mean evolving into some superior human being. It just means personal evolution, personal progress like I have done with the getting off of the drugs, for one, being open-minded, trying new things, you know, doing research. And the only step I haven't taken is getting off of sugar. I don't ingest like hundreds of grams of sugar every day. I would say on a daily basis, I probably ingest around on average 30 to maybe 50 grams of sugar. I don't drink a lot of soda. We don't have much soda in the house. But I like fruit. Fruit has sugar. I like, during the summer, peaches and plums, grapes. But I also have some chocolate. And, you know, so throughout the day, I'm having my sugar. And obviously, you need sugar. The body needs sugar for energy and blah, blah, blah. And the brain uses some sugar. And I know sugar, refined sugar especially. Sugar can maybe cause a problem with inflammation, the circulatory system of the heart, and something to do with depression, things like this, of this nature. So it's very hard for me. I have given up the alcohol and tobacco, and I don't watch the news. That's another evolutionary step, is deprogramming your mind and breaking free of religious practices, whether it's actually religion or like religiously watching the news or religiously listening to one person or one group or mindset. And once you kind of unplug yourself from the matrix, start to become more independent, and you can kind of do what I'm doing here and look around almost detached and look at things from a different perspective instead of being plugged in. And then just, you know, that's how you constantly think, and everything else that doesn't, you don't think that way is an opposition, and it's an enemy, and all that stuff. So, yeah, but there's steps, yeah, step exercise and avoiding the drugs and sugar and moderate things like that. And that's all you can do while society might be in the gutter, might be a shit show. At least it's up to you to work on improving yourself. Oh, education, getting a better job. While society might not be ideal when it comes to the jobs that are available and the direction we're headed with AI and robots and machines, like again, since the Industrial Revolution, even since agriculture, society has gone downhill. We don't no longer do what we're meant to be. I did that, you know, the greatest theft in the history of a human race, in the history of our species, was how we traded our humanity slowly over time. You watch that video, I go into that. And so we no longer have meaningful, fulfilling jobs or life. Some of our lives, some people's lives are just not very meaningful or fulfilling. And so you wonder, no wonder why there are suicide rates, you know, in this so-called wonderful society that everybody tries to pass off or write off as. But yeah, that's another step you can take, is educating yourself, getting a better job, doing what you can, looking out for you. While we all will always have exchanges and interactions with each other, opening the door for someone, you know, you need to get a flat tire, someone broke into your apartment, you got to call the police. Hopefully they don't shoot you. And, you know, obviously not all police are, you know, like that. You just, there's, you know, you have your bad cops, you have your bad parents who are abusive, you have your bad teenagers at school who are bullies. There's all kinds of bad apples, rotten apples in every aspect of society. That's just human beings. You know, everyone's capable of that. Capable. You have to look out for you as an individual and work on improving yourself. So if you have a, if you're not making a lot of money, you're at a job you don't like, and you're young, just keep your head down. And I'm sure you already know this. Keep going, working on improving yourself. Even as society burns down all around you, at least you can take the steps so that you are not necessarily a better person than everyone else. That's not really what this is about. But you can be a better you than you may have been in your past self, you know? Like I said, the exercise. Don't get into the drugs. Try to watch how much sugar you take in. And educate yourself. Try to get a better job. And all those things. You know, if you want a better job. Whatever, you know, whatever your situation may be. That's all that we can do, is try to live the best individual lives that we can, work on, evolving and progressing, in our life, whatever that might be. You know, for me, it's my own progress and all that, and evolution is trying to understand things more and gain more perspective and improve my talking here and my confidence, and my own knowledge, so I can come here and share that and try to not have too much sugar, and I don't do drugs anymore. So that's that. I might try to do cannabis again when it becomes legal and I ingest it, just to see if it helps any, or if I really need it, not to get high. I only ever did cannabis just to get high for the kicks. Which isn't too bad. But you know, I smoked it, and smoking that stuff into your lungs, I don't think is the greatest. So, you know, so it's very hard to get away from the trappings of society. Society has, you know, we're all plugged in so many ways, with having to get a car, to get a job, and all this stuff, and the trash that we create. But at least we can try to do our best at an individual basis to take the steps necessary to continuously evolve until we die, and then it'll be all for nothing. And that's it. So about an hour and a half into this video. So, and I'm sure, you know, if you know, you're listening to this, and if you're kind of like-minded like me, when you're young, maybe you're young. If you're older, you know, in your 30s, you might already have this kind of mindset, you know. But when you're young, you know, this stuff wasn't available to me when I was young. You know, all the young kids today, they have access to so many different personalities and people talking, and sometimes you don't know who's really telling the truth, or, you know, what's their hidden agenda. I have no agenda. I have no agenda. I have no pretense about myself. Sometimes I might be arrogant, and yeah, so be it. You know, I'm human. I don't think I'm better than anyone else. I don't want to say I'm better than anyone else, but I think when it comes to discipline and self-control, I might be better in that way. But I don't want to say someone who's an alcoholic is lesser than me. They just may have problems. But if there is someone out there who's not an alcoholic, I don't want to get in the whole better thing, but I think there's just, I'm not better. I don't think I'm better than anyone else. I'm just trying to work on myself. I just don't understand why more people don't do what I do. And I don't want to get into that thing of looking down at society. That's not what this is. That's not what that chart is. It's not, you know, us being better and superior. It's just society generally, with its trash and its alcohol and blah, 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 you know, is a shit show, is in the shitter, is a turd. But there are some gems in that turd. And, you know, when it comes to art and the food, or even certain individuals that are looking to evolve and, you know, just be better people, but not better, because even, you know, you want to say, oh, I'm better than you. You're still drinking alcohol and you're still watching politics. No, but because that person still has a chance to change and not be involved in politics and not drink alcohol and stop the bad habits and stop religiously ingesting the news and having one perspective. And so it's never too late for people to change. So it's not so much about being better than other people, but it is about being a better version of you, being a more evolved, progressive minded kind of person, where you're open to things and you use your using your anybody you know, use your brain. The people that constantly drink alcohol, and alcohol is great and politics is great, you know, they can, you know, they still have a chance to kind of stop to think and you know, maybe look into, you know, other alternative mindsets, and maybe think, oh, you know, maybe politics isn't so great after all, and all this. So I got to bring this to an end, because I'll never stop. So yeah, so whoever you might be, I hope you just can, you know, continue, especially if you're young, to just avoid the trappings, the pitfalls of society. Continue to work on, you know, just being, doing. We can only do our best, and we can only be the best individuals that we can be in a society that is a turd. We can try to be, you can try to be a gem on the turd of society, in the turd of society. That's the, you know, the corn. I like to say gem. I think being a corn in the turd of society, I think you're more than a kernel of corn. I think I'm more than a kernel of corn in a turd of society. So you can be your own little ruby or emerald in the turd of society. Okay. And so that's going to do it. So that's all we can do is do our best to just avoid the trappings, the unhealthy trappings, even though we're still plugged in, even though we still create trash, even though we're still using nuclear power. You know, there's only so much we really can't control. It's very hard to just go somewhere else and, you know, live, you know, in some jungle and try to, you know, when you weren't trained to live that way. Not like you could anyway. I don't want to get into the whole thing again. I got to stop. Okay. So that's it. All we can do is our best. And, you know, working on, and all you can do is the best that you can to hopefully continue to evolve and progress as a person. So again, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching. It was great having you. And I hope to see you in another video real soon. Until next time, so long and take care for now. And I forgot to mention, the once you've done all that evolving, you know, education, avoiding drugs, trying to just be the best that you can be as your own person, as your own me, as your own individual, you will evolve into your final form. It's going to happen. This is not my final form. I'm going to eventually pupate. And that's what happens, kind of like when you die, you pupate and you become a celestial entity. That's what really happens. It's not heaven and the afterlife. You're a husk. This is just the larva form. Human beings are, this is our larval stage. And then we pupate when we die in quotes. We actually pupate, and then we become celestial entities, which obviously you don't see.